once a month.
It's just like a continuous aching pain.
For about 4 hours.
It's not a cure, but what it does, it kind of temporizes his condition.
Orlando Ager undergoes what's known as a blood exchange to combat his sickle cell disease.
So basically what's happening is he has two different IVs. So one port is taking blood out of him into a waste bag over there in the back. And the other port is where blood is getting into his body. So that's sickle cell negative blood going into his body. His sickle cell blood is coming out of this port and going into a waste bag. And so you cycle the body through this a couple of times. He needs 8 units of blood each month for this procedure.
Blood donors are literally Ager's lifeline. In just the past 5 years, he has received more than 500 units of blood by having monthly blood exchanges, a staggering reality that even Ager finds hard to believe.
505 years is just incredible.
And when he thinks about the hundreds of blood donors keeping him alive.
Man, I wouldn't even know what to say to them people. I would be grateful though, very grateful. I'm very grateful right now. I'm still here, they helping me live. 1 minute I might be slowed down. Once I get that blood exchange, after a few hours, I'm back up and back to normal.
Doctors are turning to blood exchanges more often to treat sickle cell patients. The monthly procedure helps keep sickle cell complications from occurring, which means less time in the emergency room and enables a better quality of life. But they require a lot of blood at one time.
Those patients, you really need to get about 6, sometimes over 10 bags of blood every single time you do that procedure. I have a guy who's in his 40s, he needs 14 bags of blood every month. We need blood to help save people's lives. And people with sickle cell disease are desperate for blood from African-American donors. Whether you have sickle cell disease or some other medical problem that requires frequent transfusions, you need to be given blood that is as closely matched to you as possible. And the potential of that happening is better when there's a diverse blood supply.
Dr. Iffy says it comes down to trust and awareness.
So there's a lot of distrust amongst the African American community with healthcare and then healthcare research and intervention. So the people are very nervous about having their blood out there if they don't understand why it's being used, how it's being used, and who's going to benefit from it. And so I think we haven't done a really good job with communicating to the community about the importance of African-American blood donation, about how vital it is to help save the lives of members of their own community.
Orlando Ager is hoping that by sharing his story, more African-Americans will be inspired to donate blood.
A lot of people don't understand the pain we go through. Keep donating. Please keep donating. We need it more than anybody.
In Charlotte, North Carolina, I'm Kristen Yost for One Blood.